Her name is probably taken from Dying Inside, but as we know, the character in the comic is a ghostly little demon girl and nothing like the Borg Queen. Dahlia Gillespie makes the jump from a fanatical cult leader mastermind antagonist of Silent Hill 1 to an innocuous nutbar insane apocalypse preaching homeless woman.
It's mine!
Get out of
me! The QV who cast the first stone lands without a shepherd, shepherd without a flock. It's your sins which hold you here.
As we stated earlier, Christopher De Silva, Rose's husband, was further developed in the script so that there would be at least one male character. As a result, it ended up feeling like we're watching two separate things. The Wicker Man.
Oh God! Oh my God! Oh my God!
The crow must die! The crow must die! The crow!
And Law and Order.
Now, don't be trying anything, Chris, all right? We got men up here all night long. We're gonna find your wife, we're gonna find your daughter. Can't have civilians wandering around on their own.
What really happened up here?
Just let it rest in peace.
Christopher De Silva's story is pretty much just clips of him breaking into places and being tough-talked by Officer Gucci.
Gonna be city boy. I can put you in jail, or you can go home.
According to Christoph Gans, Silent Hill takes place in four dimensions. He said this in an interview with douchebag Bettenhausen of 1UP.com.
I'm in the real world, as it were, and I'm looking for my wife, my daughter, who are in another dimension of time.
We have four different Silent Hill. So we have a Silent Hill, it exists now today. We have Silent Hill like it was 30 years ago. We have Silent Hill in the fog, and we have a Silent Hill when the darkness arrives and when all the nightmares and the creatures appear.
Prior to this point in time, somewhere in the past, the timeline skewed into this tangent, creating an alternate 1985. Alternate to you, me, and Einstein, Buck. Reality for everyone else.
It's like we're hell or something.
Not four, no. Mm-hmm. In Silent Hill, everything is real and in one dimension. In Silent Hill 1, the town is the demon's projection of Alessa's nightmare. In Silent Hill 2, the spiritual power projects a nightmare tailor-made specifically for you. In Silent Hill 3, it is the power of the demon awakening inside Heather. In Silent Hill 4, the town is a complete fabrication inside Walter's whacked out head. But no matter the situation, it's always happening in
our own dimension.
In the same interview, Gans is quoted saying,
"This film is dealing with a child of 10 who's being tortured. If you want to tell the story of Silent Hill and make the meaning of that story complete, you have to face up to the torture of Elisa. It's a town of people trapped in dark dreams, and she inflicts onto the town what those people did to her body. That is, to me, the meaning of the darkness. The appearance of the town is corrupted in a way that her own flesh was wounded."
When Alessa was burned in the game, no one was involved other than herself. She did it by accident due to the stress induced by the cult's practices, as is evident in the Manifestation of Delusions article.
You've read that?
In her attempt to stop the cult by spreading the seal of Metatron throughout the town, she spreads the nightmare, also unintentionally. She doesn't do it on purpose because
she's good.
She's good. She's not bad, she's not evil, and she is not
the devil.
I always wanted to play the devil.
It is not that Cheryl is good and Alessa is bad. They're just both two iterations of the same person. A soul split in half. The Alessa we see throughout Silent Hill 1 is really Cheryl transformed back to Alessa.
So, as a Silent Hill movie, this is a failure. For a movie about a game series that is praised as one of the scariest of all, it is laughable and boring. And, you know what? Now we must burn it as a witch! Burn it! We're just kidding. We have the movie right here. That's that. The evil's gone.
Finally.
Now, 3 weeks before the movie release, a promotional item exclusively for the Space Station Portable came out called the Silent Hill Experience. It was basically a $20 advertisement for the film, plus some of the comics we mentioned earlier. And a new one!
Hey.
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 Silent Hill Hunger. And that's all there is to be said.
Yep.
We take the art, we take the media, we take the movies, we take, you know, the interviews, the videos, all these things, we put them all together, and we don't just lay it out like a DVD in a stale format. We immerse you into an actual environment from Silent Hill. But what really stands out on Silent Hill Experience is the brand new digital comic that we created called The Hunger.
Hey, we didn't read The Hunger because it was written by Scott Capuchin. Bound to be awful.
Not interested in it at all. Don't care.
Not that guy.
There were many other such spin-offs, including the Silent Hill Play novel, which was made exclusively in Japan for the Game Boy Advance as a choose-your-own-adventure story based on the events of the first game.
You know, I couldn't get very far. It's difficult to read. It was nothing special, so you're not missing out.
There are a few cell phone games, one called Orphan. As far as we can tell, it's about Alessa and her sister Karen who were dumped in an orphanage. Alessa made Karen kill everybody there. To be continued.
And there's a frightening tree with fruits that wear faces of children!
The story of the second Orphan game is completely baffling. It may or may not be about a guy named Lucas who doesn't remember anything and wasn't killed by Karen, who might be his mother. Then Vincent shows up and he knows nothing about anything, and then Lucas could be his father. The rest is just general confusion. To be continued.
Hey, did you know there is an arcade machine based on Silent Hill exclusively in Japan?
Yeah, because I wrote this part.
Okay, the game is an on-rail shooter. Similar to Resident Evil Umbrella Chronicles, where players, you know, shoot their way through familiar environments and fight monsters from all games in the series. There's barely any story, but that's fine. The game is of no consequence and actually looks kind of fun.
While many spin-offs were released for various handheld platforms, a supposedly legitimate Silent Hill game was developed for a handheld system, breaking the tradition of console releases.
End of part 7. To continue, please insert the tape marked The Real Silent Hill Experience, part 8, and the corresponding slide reel.